It's Omracer here, and today we're going to teach you on the tutorial on how to build a PC. So this has been a long time coming. With lockdown, a lot of people will be using online stuff. I know it's literally at the end of lockdown in certain ways. Yes, I know. But better late than never. And I've been planning this one out for a while, just thinking what the best way to do it this is. And now I've got the tripod, it's easier to, well, film this better really than previous mistake before. Yes, so this is only a 6th gen, nothing powerful. This isn't a gaming PC, this is just a simple basic internet use PC for someone else. You get to see how it builds and works. So there are a few things you do need for this to work. The components: processor, which we're using an i3-6100. The motherboard, which is Gigabyte H110m. Inside this box is actually around 4GB of DDR4 RAM and 120GB SATA SSD. Case, which is basically an X case, just from someone that gave me one actually. 600W power supply, and does the job, but it is 75% efficiency. Thermal paste as well. As well as that, you're gonna need the tools. Best way if you can is cable ties, two different types, because they are needed. Believe it or not, a mouse mat or an anti-static mat. And Phillips screwdriver. And if you need it, a flat tool, just to get inside some of the bits if you need it as well. And there we have it. Now it's time to start building. The steps of what we've actually got to do. First is we've got to move away the components we aren't going to need for this part, such as the power supply and the drive. And what we do is we now unbox the components. So we're going to look at the unbox the board. That will be for the case later, which is the I.O. board panel for the case. SATA cables. And then the board itself, which is a nice simple micro ATX, MATX board from Gigabyte. By the way, just to make sure you are aware, these parts are not sponsored. So we go by unboxing the board first and placing the board onto the mat like so. This is the thing, is that you've got to really get out the CPU panel, which pull the flap like so, and it lifts off the wrap. You do not take the lid off until you've done the CPU. Now this is even harder because you've got to make sure this triangle, this is vital. So now we unbox the CPU. You do have a manual, CPU itself, and you have our heatsink was used when I upgraded from a steam box many a time ago. That's the next part, is our CPU to come out. Our box to pop out. Now luckily in this regard, the thermal paste is already applied on this particular heatsink, but we'll go into that when we're ready. Is to fit the processor in. Now, be very careful how this does, because I always get this wrong sometimes. On the i3, you see the triangle. That needs to match up with that triangle there. Is to make sure that you can match those triangles up like that, and that's it. And then pop the case off, and then you push this lever down. That's it, you fitted the processor. That is step two. Step three, making sure you get these on. And I mean, can be painful, because it is not easy to get this in the right way. Now there is technically a way you need to do it, but remember the top of the board that's here, there is the CPU fan, which on this bit will give you where the board, basically where this white connector needs to go with it. Now you can do it in any way, they go in any shape, way or form, but the best way usually is the Intel logo is facing upwards and it's that way, so the cable is facing downwards, but doing that can cause it to trip the cable, so it might slice the cable here. Either going this way, so the cable faces that way, or upside down and the cable faces opposite way, like so. So for this, we're actually going to go and do opposite way. Now, be aware to make sure those holes line up, like so. And then place in the four pins with the little small round thing at the top, facing the top. Place it in like so. What you got to do is you twist them inside, push them in, then lock them with motion the opposite. And then you can basically hold the actual board from that without dropping. So you can see that's win that. Now it's time for step four, which is fitting the RAM in the memory. You've got to make sure those notches align to here. Make sure these little caps here are absolutely fitted because they do flip on one side. Some flip on both, but some flip only on the one side. Just the top one we need because obviously more RAM the better. But one DDR4 of 4 gig will be fine. And we pop in, making sure those little notches align because there's little notches there and they need to align as well. Hear that click? That's good. On this side, make sure you push in, click in. They click in, that's it. That is the RAM inside. Now remember, I didn't need to use thermal paste in this regard because this one had pre-applied thermal paste. Most non-overclocked CPUs will have the fan heatsink, which for most people overclocking is a dream but not worth having. But that's a completely different opinion on that. Now it comes to step five and we start to prepare the case. Time to move this motherboard safely out of the way, which I will move behind me. And same with the other components, because they will be needed. Except this is what we do need to stick with. So now the best way on this one is lay the case like so. We're going to slot the case out, because remember this should be screwed and not screwed in. This is where the fun bit begins. The first thing we've got to do is put the IO board in, which for this part can be tricky in certain ways. But for this bit, you rotate the case, lift the case up. I'm just showing you to lift the case up. Really, I can show you. And you see, that's what's the way you got to match. So that's backwards. That's the way that faces the board. This way faces you, or the back of the PC. Now, there is a little bit of leeway, but you've got to push in. Make sure you can push in very firmly. And sometimes they do push in nicely. Sometimes you need a little bit of push to hit the slam. And see, that's now firmly pushed in. Now it's time for step six, which essentially is the pass by. So this is not a modular, because... And if you need to make sure you've got all the cables. Now you do get a kettle lead with this one. And essentially, you have to outbox it yourself. And this is what these look like. So this is, like I said, the boring old. This is where we have to make sure. So the way it works on power supplies is the label must face you. So in this regard, the label must face you on that way. So you see where the power supply is facing, and it slots in different ways of cases. So in this regard, there's a little joiner there which stops you the power supply from moving, is basically where we need to put it and make sure it faces. And then you've got four screws, which this is when our screwdriver comes into play, or ideally more of them, of these style screws with slightly longer edges there, because at least then you know what's going on. So what we're going to do here, align the power supply up to the holes. Now in good cases, the case you, if you get a case and buy a proper case, you will have screws like this given to you as part of the package, a lifesaver. But in this case, use what you got. And they are all four screws in and dusted. So as you see, that is basically how the power supply fits in. Fitting the SSD into one of these, because it's not going to fit easily. Unbox the case, and this is the bracket, a rail, a budget rail. Now these do come with screws, which is really handy. You basically put it in this way so the holes still match and align like so. So then the back end is here towards the edge and the front end is here. Once you've matched those holes up, screw them in. Now, this can be trickier because you've got to do it in both angles. Open the case on our side. So now we've got to go on the side to slot in from upside down this particular instance of case. Remember, this side, it's got to be this shown on this side. So there's a case of sliding it in. Sometimes the screws that go with it do not work, so you have to use different screws. Now that's safely, still got a little bit of leeway. So we have to put the screws provided by SSDNow for this particular one are pretty much rubbish. So yeah, that's now in place. Now it's time for step 8, which is to fit everything in. So the case is like this. Make sure the IO board is safely like that. Now, you should see some posts, which are very important for things to all to work. Now, those posts is where the board will go. The key is to make sure that those posts are in the right place for this board to fit. So now is the moment of truth to fit this board where it needs to be fitted, because this can be complicated if done improperly. And making sure the board matches the holes like so. If you see that, you are good to go. And then it's maybe pushing in with the screws and the posts and making sure those all go in. Now you see at the top there isn't, so it will have to be pulled out because you've got to move a post from one to another. We will fit the board in like so. But these screws will be the best for it. Now it's always going best bottoms upwards. Because some screws will not fit correctly. PC from the boards and from the seats again, you know it's very, very stable. Now, the almost final step of the wiring. So firstly, you've got the 24-pin ATX, which goes in here. So it goes into there. Then you've got the power for the CPU. Now these actually split for the ATX 12-volt, which is these. You make sure the bottom flap here goes in, and only one of them will go in the correct way, like I said, like so. And then you've got the wiring of your SATA devices. So for example, flip the case like so. Sorry, get the wire in all the drives. Again, because there's only two things, that's fine. Obviously more drives mean more. And then sometimes you need a little bit of pressure to make sure they're firmly in, like so. You've got SATA wiring to go in. With these, the right angle usually goes at the top and then the bottom angle at the bottom. Now in this regard, because of that little extra gap on this case, you cannot use the right angle for the SATA hard for the SSD. You have to use that for the DVD drive. As you can see, it fits like so. And these are all SATA, well, free SATA free, aka 6 gigs a second. So that one clicks in there. And you can see, making sure that fits in correctly, making sure SATA zero should always be your SSD. It's a really good way of thinking for it. And you hear the click. And that's essentially got the last bits of the bottoms. Now, to making sure, you've got to make sure you've got the HD audio wire, which is this wire here from the case. and it goes in. Which actually, there's make sure the little hole, and make sure it matches the pin on that little hole. It's very, very hard to see, but you should be able to see it. And then you've got the USBs, which again, similar design, into the white ports at the bottom there, which says USB 1 and USB 2. Either way, that's how you get the front USB ports working. And then it's the hardest part of the front port wiring. Now, sometimes it is actually better to do this upside down, but you've got these. You know, power, LEDs, HDD, and everything like that. Best way, when you go for this, here, you've got the triangle, very small, you can probably see. The minus goes at the top. Now, the power LED and that are separate. There we are. That is essentially how they look at the top there. The sort of final step of making sure it works with the telly. You see, you've got to plug everything in. Now we're not for the basics to make sure it actually posts, which basically means a picture on the screen. Plug in USBs. And in this case, it's got HDMI. So we'll be plugging in HDMI and a kettle lead. Now, when you do plug in, make sure it's the right way up. Like so. The moment of truth is to switch on and see on the input. You're in. That means it has posted and you are up and running. As you see, Gigabyte up, and you're in the bar setup. So now, that is part one sorted of this tutorial, almost. Now it posts, we've got the fun challenge of tidying cables, which is the hardest part of probably any tutorial in the building a PC at all. Now, it's making sure that you can actually get at these cables when you need them, but at the same time, you don't want them making too much of a mess. So some of them, like these, have all been tidied up anyway, but some have not been so lucky. And the first thing to do is disconnect the SATA cables to make life a lot easier in the long run, and also the ATX. So basically disconnect the power cables for this part of tidying up cables, because that's the hardest part. And the best way is actually wrapping them around the back. So flip the case over. Some cases will have this lucky, some cases are not so lucky, which always check the case manual to find that one out. But it will be like organizing, for example, you go around the back for these cables, or say make sure that they are in the right way. So there's little reasons like this, just to make it a lot easier when you're building a PC. You have that. Now, best way cabling tidy is always making sure you can stiffly get the cables out without damaging any part. Because sometimes, for example, the ATX cable, like this one, is stiff the correct way, like so. And any holes and slits do help. Which now, you can start to see, it's much, much tidier. Where we use some of the smaller ones first, like
these small ones. And just zip where you think is relevant. For example, you grab these two together. Now, if you hear the no grinding sound, you've gone it wrong way. So you've got to flip them the right way. And flip them. Actually, more likely be on the other side. Here. The bigger base cable. If you do want to completely make them permanent, make sure to cut these zips. If you do want a bit of leeway, then don't cut the zips. And then you can... There we go. And now you can see how much of a cleaner feeling that will be. And then essentially it is the last step of pinning it all together. And the problem with the back casing is making sure the back casing fits, because sometimes after you do one of these cases, the back casing doesn't fit. If you get that kind of issue where the screw is stuck in, always leave something under it and then push it. And it will come out as intended. But you do need something a bit thicker screw-wise for that kind of situation. And there you have it, PC part one of how it's built. As you've seen there, you basically fit everything together, make sure it's all cable tied at the end, but after testing it, because always make sure to test it before you actually tie it together so you don't have to undo it. But that is all working. Now it's time for the second part soon, to install Windows or any operating system you want, depending on what you want. In this case, we're going for Windows 10. I will see you for that tutorial. Omracer is out.